Naglen laga DGB Rupin Sharma braje ekta press conference dia homoi tai kuise ki Naglen state te police department kan when it comes to security tai kan alag ekta approach evolve kurigina ahibole ase kuise tai kuise ki from Monday onwards that is 8 July all over Naglen day 150 to 200 locations te police checking thakibo aru itu checking to throughout Naglen thakibole ase which will take place simultaneously. Kutagura homoi kayum taluktar laka case opportunity kutaguise. Amikan sob manu janiase kayum taluktar new market laka GP ke murder kura laka opore. Tai guise ki itia investigation process jula nimide iman detail to go na parbo libi
This is a sort of an unscheduled press conference, so if you want to ask for any figures specifically, you can raise questions, we will hand over later. Okay. General law and order situation, you are all aware of. We have had successful general elections, successful ULB elections. Again, I would like to congratulate CP Dimapur and entire Nagaland police for doing a wonderful job throughout the state. During the elections, we have had fairly good success in all aspects of policing in Nagaland, including drugs, catching of arms and ammunition, liquor. And it's not, some of it is not just restricted to only Dimapur and Koima, but also throughout the state. Say, for example, Longlang and Mon also have done a good job in this. You were all a part of the morning flagging off ceremony. So the idea is to get more vehicles into the state police, and in Dimapur and Koima, since mobility is a problem, we thought we will go for two wheelers so that the response time is shorter. For the time being, we have equipped about 15 of these vehicles, these bikes with GPS. We will endeavor that we can equip as many as possible, maybe up to 80 of them with GPS, so that the officers in Dimapur and Koima and maybe even in the PHQ can have an integrated look at where is the location of individual response team, so that we can have a faster response. As I mentioned briefly in the morning session, there are certain other things which will also be coming up in the next, say, 10 days or 15 days. Since it is all work in progress, I will not want to divulge all that. But whenever we do adopt that tactic, we will make sure that you are aware of it. But one thing which probably we will start from Monday, we were thinking of giving a sort of a press note for this. But since we are meeting here, I thought I will appeal to everybody, to the media. And also a separate press note can go. We are thinking of evolving a slightly different approach in security. So you must have all seen that our IR and NAP patrols, which are going out, they are going out for 8-hour shifts or 6-hour shifts in a day. So we are thinking of changing that system a little bit for at least one shift in a day. For the time being, one shift in a day, the patrols will not be for 8 hours or 6 hours. They will be for a shorter duration. But they will cover almost the entire state. Okay, so the idea is to cover as many places as possible, not only just IRs. It is IRs, NAP, DF, the DF reserve people. So maybe next week, sometime next week onwards, you will, the public of Nagaland will see around checking that about 150 to 200 locations taking place simultaneously throughout the state. Okay. I would, while this is a new initiative, I would request or solicit the cooperation of the media and the public on this. It's a new process. It is a new initiative to make all of us secure. Initially, since we are also going to be evolving how to do it, there may be some inconvenience to the public. The same vehicle may be stopped at 2, 3, 4 places. Okay, but this is because we are also evolving. Slowly, we will try to work on it slightly more scientifically and try to ensure that people are not troubled at multiple places in the state when they are traveling. The idea is to have an element of surprise in all these checkings and have a, so far as possible, have a carpet coverage of security in the state for whatever duration. I'm saying a shorter duration. I'm not saying whether it will be 10 minutes or 5 hours. It will be less than 6 hours. So, because if we tell you how many, what hours, then everybody will sort of guess. It is from 9 o'clock, it is 1 hour, it will be till 10 o'clock only. So, we don't want to tell you that. So, the timing, we will centrally monitor it from the PHQ, what time they are going to be deployed. But we intend having a carpet coverage for checking of vehicles and persons throughout the state for shorter durations. This element of surprise, I think, will put the criminals and the antisocial elements on the back foot because they don't know when we will come and which locations we will be present at. So, hopefully, it will make everybody secure. If anyone from the public wants to share information during that process about criminals or antisocial activities, most welcome. We will reward that. And even for our own police personnel who are going to be part of these MVCPs, if they catch any criminal or antisocial element or criminal activity, they will also be suitably rewarded. So, I request the cooperation of everybody in Nagaland on this aspect. And you will bear with us for, say, about 7-8 days, 10 days, till the time we make a better arrangement so that less inconvenience is caused to the public. Yes, we have, but we will not want to go into details because these are operational issues. The whole operations will get jeopardized. We have leads, okay, but no specifics. As and when we get to, when the operational work is completed, we'll let you know. Only this much we'll tell. We have picked up 5 people. We are on the right track. Picked up and arrested 5 people. We are on the right track, but we will not go into further details because more operations, more work is in progress. Let me also say that yes, Baharuddin was a very big success for Nagaland Police and for the entire law enforcement community in Northeast. But probably he's not the biggest one also. He's a more notorious one, but he's not probably the bigger or the biggest one. There are bigger people than him, which we are aware of. Baharuddin is wanted in multiple cases throughout Northeast. We have been in touch with some of the other state police forces where they have he's wanted. He's also wanted in a case of DRI, where his co-accused have been sentenced already to 10 years. Okay, so he is wanted in at least 5 to 6 cases in Nagaland. At least I am saying 5 to 6 cases in Nagaland. Currently, he has been booked under the preventive detention provisions of the PIT and DPS Act. He is lodged in the central jail in Dimapur. I think it is around 4.5 crore or something like that, roughly around 4 crores. I'm not sure about it. As I said, I've not come with the figures, but so roughly you can multiply 35 multiplied with the price of a Bolero plus about say 1,10,000 for a bike, roughly that much. See, it was a very considered view that we went for the bikes. One is for the traffic reason and the other is because the same amount of budget, we have to maximize the input output that we get. So we thought we'll buy more bikes so that we can have more mobility for our people. And this is state government. Just state government, yeah. I mean, okay, let me also just clarify a certain part of it, okay. There is a scheme of Government of India which is called Modernization of Police Forces, okay. It comes in various forms. The state allocation for Nagaland under that scheme was just about 4 crores last year, okay. So, don't think that we are getting everything from the central government and we are fully dependent on the central government, or central government gives us everything. So, a lot of it, what we get is also from the state government. So, this particular component is from the state government funds. There are a few operational things we have done which don't want to put it in the public domain. We have put solid systems in place where we are able to detect movements of people. However, honestly, as a policeman, I'm saying it is not possible to check every person and every vehicle. Okay, so this will keep happening. Our best shot is better public cooperation. In fact, for this, you are aware that on my social media handles, I had already mentioned once that we'll give 1,000 rupees reward per soap case which is caught. Okay, not 1,000 for helping us with information, but you give us information, once we catch it, we'll give 1,000 rupees. Khabar dile tate bhi panchta ase koli na dibo de. Khabar dibi dhore le to 5,000 dibo panchta thagile. Itu ase. So, I have given this already on my social media handles. I think it got a lot of good vibes. In addition to that, the Narcotics Control Bureau of Government of India has a scheme of rewarding of sources and investigating officers for catching drugs or giving information of drugs. We had made decent seizures, but the scheme is that we first give the reward and then the Government of India reimburses that. Okay, so we were not in a position to give that reward because we sort of did not have money for that. Okay, but recently, in the past say 20 days or so, Nagaland government, Honorable Chief Minister and Deputy Chief Minister have approved a fund of 25 lakh rupees as a recurring amount for giving rewards to, whether it is to officers or to sources, for that. 25 lakh rupees, so which means I can give a reward of up to 1 lakh and then I will get it sent to Narcotics Control Bureau. They will reimburse, but my 25 lakh remains. Okay, so now we are sort of not going to be constrained in giving information, but that information has to be specific. People, I would request people to come forward with information, meet us, meet the senior officers. Okay, I think if you meet CP Dimapur and IGs, DIGs and IGs and above, I think we can maintain secrecy of the person who is sharing that information. So that is one thing that I wanted to bring it to the notice of everybody. Be grateful to the state government. Then another thing is where people stay. You know, people are coming from Manipur or from other parts of the country. Either from Manipur, it is bringing drugs. The other part of the country, people are taking drugs here from. Okay, you recollect a case where two people from Punjab had been caught. So this drug was going to Punjab, right on the border to Tarantaran in on the Punjab Pakistan border. So we need to check the places where people are staying in Kohima, Nagaland, Dimapur, various parts of Nagaland. So we are trying to come up with some sort of a system for firstly tenant verifications, and second about hotel checkings. Okay. Briefly, we will come to more detail. We'll give you a PowerPoint presentation in due course once we start off. But briefly, in Delhi and all, they already have the tenant verification systems. Okay. So we will sort of modify it as per our requirements and use a similar thing. We will request all the landlords to cooperate with us, all the NGOs, wards, everyone to cooperate with us. Because what happens is someone from anywhere in the country, a criminal will come and keep a bag with you. You are caught with the bag in your house. You don't know, but finally you are caught. Okay? Similar is the thing with transporters and transport also. It is the driver sometimes who is doing it without the Malik knowing what is happening. Okay. So, leasing of, another thing is a recent case that we caught was, there are some, again, it is a request to this particular community. There is a group of companies or some business establishments in Dimapur and Kohima who are renting out vehicles or leasing vehicles on, say, 2,000, 5,000 rupees per day. People come to you, say, ek din laga divi. So you take 5,000 rupees, allow the vehicle to go. In one particular case, we caught a vehicle which was carrying 110 soap cases. It was vehicle on lease. So please rent a car or whatever services by this name. I have discussed with CP Dimapur, IG Range and ADG LO. We would want to formally invite them even through your channel, through your medium. Come and discuss with us so that we put a system in place. So that if anyone is renting a vehicle from you, please inform us. Okay. Then if the vehicle is caught with a drug or with an antisocial, then the vehicle is not going to be held accountable. It's because this fellow is taking your vehicle, you don't know what he's doing. On the way back, he's bringing that drug or whatever. Okay. So the similar thing I want to request even for the transporters who are plying their vehicles into Manipur. So please come meet us. You can meet either me or ADG LO or CP Dimapur or IG Range. We want to put the system in place where we want to protect your, give you shelter for good work. But people in your setup who are black sheep, we want to caution them. The other thing is about the hotels. Even currently, the hotels are supposed to give daily statement of occupancy to the police, to the police station. Currently, it is being given in hard copies. We are planning to sort of make it digitized. So as and when someone comes to your hotel, you upload the details. It is available with them, available with us. Okay, so we also want to solicit their cooperation for doing this. You don't know who is staying there, but at least if we know who is a criminal. You don't know who is a criminal. So if you tell us who is staying, we will be able to check that criminal or that antisocial activity. So as you, what you asked, I'm answering your question. What other initiatives? So these are the initiatives which I call it territory denial to the criminals. We try to deny space to the criminals. They're not able to use this, these facilities for making Nagaland unsafe. More things will come. We'll keep you informed as and when they happen. These are internal. There are internal some instructions which exist. Okay. As you also said that it is primarily the job of the district administration, state government. There are many methods of doing it. But I think the basic method is probably the sharing of the database of ILPs that they are issuing. If I don't know who has been issued an ILP, how do I check who has not been issued? Okay, so I think putting that system in place or a similar system in place is the beginning. Whatever directives are issued or are going to be issued, it is a secondary thing. First, we have to have a system which is good, where it is transparent, which tells us who is having an ILP, who is not having an ILP. So I think there is some work which is required to be done. I'm sure government is, there is a committee headed by the Deputy CM. Yeah, there was a committee headed by the Deputy CM, I think about 10 days back or something, a report has been submitted. So we will probably await further instructions from the government before doing anything. Again, since you raised this about the documents, two things. One is stolen vehicles. Please don't buy stolen vehicles. People will give you vehicles at a cheaper rate in Nagaland. If anyone is giving you a Fortuner which is worth 35 lakh for say 10 lakh, please presume that it is a stolen vehicle. I would put it this way. Okay. The person who is selling to you may not be a criminal. He also may have got it like this. Okay. So one is that. The second is from our records, from whatever checking we have done, there are a number of vehicles which are running with applied for and unregistered. Okay. We have cautioned earlier, we will start picking up these vehicles and not releasing them. These are a major cause of problem. Yeah. unregistered vehicles, applied for vehicles, and then also vehicles which were auctioned from various government departments in the past, which are still running with NL10 number plates. Okay, not only is this a crime, but you are also depriving the state government of revenue. Okay, you are obviously you are not registering a vehicle. If it is 5,000 rupees, state government gets 5,000 rupees, no? So I'm going to, we are going to start catching these vehicles and not allowing them to ply on the roads. Some of the challenges that we will face is, one is training our own manpower, okay? Because there are some changes which are there, some of it is training our manpower. The second is there are certain mandatory provisions in the new laws, for example, forensic recording of evidence through mobiles and all. So that, unfortunately, our capabilities there are not very good. Most of the states are like that probably. But since we have a resource constraint, our capabilities and equipments are not very good. So hopefully over a period of say year or so, 1 year, 1.5 years, we should be able to make up.
Regarding the unregistered vehicles without number plates, therefore we have started seeing that, like, and unless they get it registered, we are not visiting it now, sir. The last about 2 weeks back, and throwing away, you know, like, as you know, like, one thing, it's somewhat like satirical, but then we police are empowered to enforce, but we are not allowed to collect part of taxes. So that way, like, enforcing it only wrong parking, or where we could have noticed, like, parking for only two wheelers or all those, and we must have seen, like, some banks that just put up notices like parking for bank staff only. They put up in their own effort. So we have started removing all those also, and we have warned them also. So, like, parking in long parking areas, or all those, we are taking daily action.
See, last year when this multi-level parking in Kohima was inaugurated, last year I think by Mr. Hardeep Puri in Kohima, there also Honorable CM mentioned this, that we need to be more disciplined. Okay, so we don't need to be disciplined only in the parking place. Okay. I think we need to be also disciplined in our town and country planning. That if you are making a building which is having 100 shops, then you need to have space for 100, 200 people. Okay, I think that is where the problem is. That is where the problem is, not just the indiscipline among drivers and people, but the planning part of it. When you are, unfortunately, we don't have a system where people are taking, say, permits. And everybody will probably start construction on its own in his. So we just hope, my friend Sandeep is saying, hopefully with the ULBs coming into place, this they will probably try to plan it much better. The town planning will become much better. Although there may be other departments, but then urban local bodies, I think hopefully they will be able to plan it much better. I think going by my experiences elsewhere, that these parking and all could be a good money earner for the local bodies also, if they do it properly. So that will solve the problem, that will give them money, and with that money, further problems can be solved, you know, more parking spaces and all. So you need money for all this. You don't get money for all this. So hopefully these urban local bodies will bring in a lot of good things to the state.
And sir, like, regarding the traffic management, I should say that I think our friends from the media will agree with me also. I think Dimapur is one of the best traffic management in the whole of Northeast. I've been here as CP for around 1 year, 7 months now. But on any day, I've never stopped in a certain location for even 1 minute. So traffic management, I think we have one of the best in the market, in the entire Northeast, among the towns and cities.
Yeah, my friend IG Range will load.
Thank you, sir. I think the problem of traffic in Dimapur as well as in Kohima, as already mentioned, is not just an enforcement issue. There are engineering issues, there are educational issues, because enforcement is just one aspect of traffic management. But there are many other aspects which I think equally important. You know, we have the four E's, which is the enforcement, the efficiency, the engineering, and the education part. So all this has to go together. That is one aspect. Second aspect, what sir has already mentioned. See, the kind of building constructions that are on, especially by the roadside, if you see from here, if you go around the Timapur, you will see that a lot of buildings are encroaching into public space. Not only that, if you see that, in fact, you know, the drainage capacity is also not there. The water is actually draining down into the roads. So that is one of the reasons why the roads are also not, you know, we don't have durability of roads, and that the roads get, you know, washed off, or we develop potholes and all that. So these are larger aspects where, you know, that the aspect of town planning is also important. Or the aspect of, you know, if the roads are not broad enough, ultimately, public has to park the vehicle by the roadside. Yes, if there's a very latent violation, then of course police can always intervene. Police intervenes and then we take necessary action. But these are larger issues of governance, these are larger issues of urban planning, and also, you know, the awareness and the fine appreciation of what constitutes a public space and a private space for all the citizens. You know, public space is public good, and it is for the common good of each and every one of us. So I think a distinction has to be made in terms of all this, you know, the finer aspects of what defines public good and what defines our private space. And if that happens, maybe gradually, you know, the infrastructure will improve and things will be easier to enforce. So that is the way forward. Thank you.
Anyone? Anything else? We'll come back to you later with the more things which are required to be told. Please continue your cooperation, not only coverage about the good works of Nagaland Police or the government, but also please try to bring to our notice anything that requires our attention. Okay, this is equally important. We also learn with people pointing out our mistakes. Please let us know if we can improve somewhere. Thank you very much.